When we think about the games of our childhood, we can definitely agree that Lego is one of the favorite games for so many kids around the world. Personally for me, it was a white box filled with those random bricks, different colors, that gave me so much curiosity and satisfaction. A little bit less satisfaction when I used to just step on it with my bare foot. Years after, when I started to work as a designer and develop my method, I kept on thinking what was so different about this game, what was so special, and most of it, what made it timeless. I realized there was not the bricks and not the colors, it was simply the direct approach they had for the users. No fixed solution were ever given, but just tools for people to interact and create their own unique and special reality. A few years after, when VAC Foundation asked me to design an outdoor cinema for Venice Biennale, and by that to reflect upon 100 years for the Russian Revolution, I thought that would be a perfect opportunity to experiment with that same approach, creating a platform for people activities rather than a fixed solution for that brief. So we created Street Cinema. Street Cinema is a multimedia adjustable installation that invites passers and visitors to engage with the urban context and the art around them. The flexibility of the structure gives people the freedom to choose how and when to use the structure, and by that, triggering surprising activities that can be screening, it can be conference, and of course, just a spontaneous stop with friends. Historically, the pavilion, the installation, is referencing the Soviet Agit trains and Agit cinema that were considered during the Civil War the most effective way to spread the information among the country. Our idea was not only to reflect about the past and the present, but actually it was to see if we can revisit and reuse this mechanism that became the most effective way to unite people and engage them in conversation all around the country. The design follows the notion that when creating platforms rather than fixed solution, endless possibilities will be created. Most important in this is that when we work in this method, we're automatically placing the users as generators of contents, and by that, fostering the very strong idea of wisdom of crowd. This, in fact, is exactly the same revolution we could see with websites like Wikipedia or SoundCloud, that not like before, they were not placing the users as consumer of services and information, but placing them as generators of contents. That, of course, brought us to places we could never imagine to be in. How to take this idea and make it a physical reality? How to technically allow all this variety of uses? And more than this, how to communicate this to people from far in order to incentivize their imagination and to allow them to think what kind of use they want to make with the space? Well, the pavilion is made out of a modular wooden structure that can contract and expand and adjust to the activity held within the space. At the same time, a system, a mechanism of curtains allow these activities to be hidden or visible from the outside and therefore be intimate or open to the crowd. Like in this picture, we see Russian artist Olga Zhitnina performing a very intimate show to an occasional crowd. That gave us a lot of satisfaction to see this kind of activity. Eventually, the pavilion can be built or unbuilt to leave the space free to clear the site for other activities to take place. Of course, when we work with this kind of method and with this kind of freedom, we should ask ourselves, what happens if this freedom is channeled, is used for unpleasant or even offensive activities in the public space? For that, I thought it would be interesting to check the example of Mobike and their system of bike sharing. It is true that those bikes are thrown over all over the sidewalks in different cities, disturbing the traffic, disturbing people's lives. But it is also true that the possibilities it created in terms of mobility and democratization of transportation are much bigger than that disturbed. So usually we think about design and about life generally in terms of solutions and in terms of answering a specific problem. I prefer to think in terms of creating possibilities and inspiration. By placing a new art installation in the public space, we're actually triggering people to interact and to create conversation that fit in a way to what we have as a rhythm of contemporary culture. I believe that when adopting this kind of method of creating platforms and open solutions for, instead of fixed solutions, what we're actually doing is adopting an imaginative mindset that challenges us to be more creative and more playful while creating the reality we live in. This, in turn, is inspiring us to immerse ourselves in different and new adventures and possibilities we could never imagine to be in. Thank you very much.